Hello, and welcome to the fifth web lecture of the fourth module of the MELDE project, which concerns e-safety. This module aims to present a range of scenarios and ways to stay safe online. The e-safety module consists of five topics, which are risks and responsibilities online, protecting personal data, digital copyrights, online misinformation and harmful content, and cyberbullying. As part of the fourth topic, which is online misinformation and harmful content, issues like the differences between a genuine and a copycat website, the evaluation and reporting of fake websites, the concept of fake news, and the importance of reporting fake websites are going to be discussed. In this web lecture, you will be introduced to fake websites and the concept of fake news. Nowadays, copycat websites tend to have a very similar look and feel to the genuine site. The logo and branding of the official site are often included, and the sites are very realistic and deceptive. The main purpose of these websites is to obtain money from users or fish their personal data, like credit card numbers, bank accounts, or just their login credentials, in order to harm them and gain money illegally. Copycat websites are even using tools and search engine optimization in order to be better ranked on search engines so that users would not question their credibility. The biggest problem is that these sites are not always illegal, so it is crucial to be able to spot the telltale signs of a copycat website. There are some common themes and features that copycat websites adopt that can help a user to distinguish them from a genuine official site. First, they use paid search engine advertisements. The paid search engine advertisements are at the top of the search engine page, marked with the tag ad next to the URL. The genuine sites often appear in the organic SEO section below the ads segment of the search engine results. Also, copycat websites use a similar URL with the genuine site. Pay close attention to the URL of the page. The suffix of the URL will indicate if the site is official or copycat. For example, if the suffix is gov.uk, this indicates that the site is authentic. Otherwise, if the suffix is a .org, it is not certain that the site is official. Then read the homepage carefully. Check for any grammatical or spelling mistakes that would indicate that the site is not very professional before you enter any personal data or information. The footer of a genuine site is usually dedicated to information about a business or agency. Afterwards, check the payment options. If the site has a bank transfer as a payment option, this should alert you that it is a potentially copycat website. The right to get your money back when you have used a bank transfer is less strong than when you use credit card, debit card, or a PayPal account. Also, check the connection security indicators. At the beginning of the URL, there is a connection security indicator, HTTP or HTTPS. The last one indicates that the site is encrypted in order to protect the user's details. This S at the end stands for the word secure. Unfortunately, a secure connection does not always indicate that the site is safe. Many fake websites use free SSL certificates. After, check for online reviews. Both copycat and genuine websites might have reviews. Always check to see that these reviews have come from a variety of independent sources and were posted on various dates. Look out for strange or lots of similar reviews, as they may indicate an internal or paid-for source and not a genuine customer. Finally, check for trust marks. In Europe, there are several trust marks for a genuine site. These logos, however, do not guarantee a genuine site, as someone could have copied them. These marks should be judged along with the overall website. If you have given money to a suspected copycat website, the first step is to demand a refund. If this doesn't work, then you should report the website to the appropriate government department, agency, or local government organization. You can also report the website through the Report Malicious Software page of Google, through the Fraud Report page of Mozilla, through the Report International Scams page of econsumer.gov, or finally, through the Report Unsafe Website tool of Internet Explorer. Fake news includes articles that are intentionally and verifiably false and could mislead readers. In order to evaluate a news article, you can search on websites like Google, Snopes.com, FastCheck.org, LeadStories.com, TruthOrFiction.com, and finally on MediaBiasFastCheck.com to find out if the story has already been shown as false. You can also evaluate if a picture is fake news by searching on the tinyeye.com website or on getsurfaced.com. To work out whether something is fake news, you can first read the About Us section of the site, which might state openly if the site is fake news one, but in the sense of a satire or entertainment. Afterwards, you can check the page links, and if there aren't any, chances are that the site is fake. Also, check if another page news has reported the same story. If not, it might be made up. After, you can check if the reporter has quoted more than one source and what you know about the people quoted. You can also check the evidence the reporter provides for their story. Afterwards, check for pop-up advertisements and clickbait. Many fake news sites get paid for posting ads that readers click on. Finally, you can check the punctuation of the article and for words that play on emotions. Multiple exclamation points and words that are written on capital letters give away a probably fake news article. Unfortunately, not everyone is well equipped in order to separate quality and genuine information from false and fake information, and there is no easy way to fix the problem, even if companies like Facebook and Google are trying to do so by tweaking their algorithms. The real solution must come from all of us who need to be more skeptical and better equipped to rate the quality of information we encounter and report the fake news websites. For this reason, it is important to be trained to media literacy and equipped with tools that will allow us to distinguish the legitimacy of information we read. In this web lecture, you were introduced to the differences between a genuine and a copycat website, to the ways of reporting a fake website, to the ways of evaluating and identifying fake news, and to the importance of reporting fake news websites. In the next web lecture, you will be introduced to the concept of cyberbullying. If you have any questions, you can find us at the Melde Project's website. Also, you can find this material in the Project C platform. Thank you for listening.